What's up, guys? Omni here. You know how it go. You know how it goes. Another day, another video. For those of you guys who watch my videos every day, you've probably heard me say this before, but there are three things in life that you cannot escape: death, taxes, and being canceled on Twitter. And apparently, guys, it seems that not even Twitter itself can avoid being canceled by Twitter. It be your own ninjas. We all knew this day was coming, okay? You know, everyone has been canceled on Twitter at this point, like PewDiePie, Chris Pratt, President Trump, or ex-President Trump, Matt Pat, Kevin Hart, Jay Schlatt, Fitz, name it. If you're a person on Twitter, you have been canceled, and or you will be eventually canceled on Twitter at one point in time. So we kind of all knew this day was coming. So, you know, I felt like, obviously, since we cover on this show all the time how people get canceled on Twitter, that this would be an appropriate video to make where we talk about how Twitter essentially just got canceled by itself. So yeah, yesterday this tweet was going viral. A lot of people have been asking me to talk about it. It says Twitter refused to remove CP because it didn't violate policies. Lawsuit. So yeah, trigger warning for those of you who are not into those kind of things or whatever. I'm going to be reading this article. Obviously, this video isn't monetized, so I ain't making squat today, but you know, obviously I wouldn't try to monetize this anyway. But yeah, like, this is absolutely crazy. This title doesn't even make sense to me. Twitter refused to remove CP. When I read this title, when I look at the article, I think to myself, you know what? This has got to be like a lie, right? This got to be cap. It's got to be some misinformation. Maybe some bots happen. What is going on? What kind of big corporation would just flat out be like, nah, keep that on my website? You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to read this. A lot of people ask me to just talk about it and see what my opinions and thoughts are and kind of just, I guess, acknowledge it. But it is important to understand, guys, that there is some awful things that already exist on Twitter, like the map community and places where it's extremely dangerous for kids on the internet. I talked about this in a previous video as well, how Twitter just has some places and some spaces that you should not be in, and it's very dangerous. So right off the bat, and you guys probably can't see the URL because I think it's like hidden or something like that, but there has been a change. Originally on the first post, it said Twitter refused to remove it, but here on the URL it's saying that Twitter sued for allegedly refusing, which is a big deal. You know, that's the whole, they just basically switched in betas. Like, one thing being like, hey, the difference between saying alleged is one person saying, hey, you did XYZ, period. And the other ones be like, what I had heard was that you did something, which is a very big difference from hearing someone versus claiming that someone did so, because it could put you in, you know, liability for, you know, false claiming somebody. So yeah, that's a big difference already when you come to the website. So yeah, the article reads as follows. Twitter refused to take down widely shared pee images and videos of teenage trafficking victim because an investigation didn't find a violation of the company's policies, the scathing lawsuit alleges. The federal suit filed Wednesday by the victim and his mother and the Northern District of California alleges Twitter made money off the clips, which showed a 13-year-old engaged in sex acts and are a form of CP, or in the suit states. What? They made money? Wait, what? The teen, who is now 17 and lives in Florida, is identified as John Doe and was between 13 and 14 years old when sex traffickers posing as 16-year-old female classmate started chatting with him on Snapchat, the suit alleges. Doe and all the traffickers allegedly exchanged nude photos before the conversation turned to blackmail. If the teen didn't share more graphic photos and videos, the explicit material he'd already sent would be shared with his parents and his coach and his pastor and others, the suit states. Jesus Christ, this is absolutely messed up. Continues, Doe, acting under duress, initially complied and sent videos of himself performing acts and was also told to include another kid in his videos, which he did, the suit claims. Eventually, Doe blocked the traffickers and they stopped harassing him, but at some point in 2019, the video surfaced on Twitter under two accounts that were known to share child CP material, court papers allege. Over the next month, the videos would be reported to Twitter at least three times. First on December 25th, 2019, which is 2 years ago, or roughly about 1 year ago, actually. But the tech giant failed to do anything about it until a federal law enforcement officer got involved, the suit states. What the heck, bro? Why is it taking an actual federal law enforcement officer to get involved for someone to get a video like this taken down? That's absolutely wild. Let me calm down though. Hold on, because maybe there's two sides to the story, okay? Because this doesn't make sense. We're going to try to make sense of it while reading it, but so far this doesn't kind of make sense. Doe became aware of the tweets in January 2020 because they've been viewed widely by his classmates, which subjected him to teasing, harassment, vicious bullying, and led him to become suicidal, court records show. While Doe's parents contacted the school and made police reports, he filed a complaint with Twitter, saying there were two tweets depicting CP of himself and they need to be removed because they were illegal, harmful, and were in violation of the site's policies. A support agent followed up and asked for a copy of Doe's ID so they could prove it was him, and after the team complied, there was no response for a week, the family claims. Okay, so right off the bat here, I thought maybe what had happened was maybe they'd never talked to a specific person. Like, just reading the title, I'm thinking, okay, maybe they got hit up with like Twitter's boss. Like, you know, like on YouTube, if you complain to YouTube and you say, hey, YouTube, like, hey, my channel got deleted, you might get a response that says, hey, thanks for reaching out. we'll get back to you shortly. Hopefully everything is okay. You know, it'll be some automated message or some bot. So I thought maybe with Twitter, maybe there was a bot and they just didn't get in touch with a person, but a support agent actually followed up asking for ID. I don't think a bot can do that. So this was an actual live human being has already been, you know, brought into the process. Anyway, continue forward. Around the same time, Doe's mother filed two complaints to Twitter reporting the same material, and for a week she also received no response, the suit states. So based on this suit, so far at least 2 weeks have gone down since they've, you know, claimed like, hey, take this very, very harmful material down and here's ID and proof, and nothing has happened. Finally, on January 28th, Twitter replied to Doe and said they would not be taking down the material, which had already racked up over 167,000 views and 2,000 retweets, the suit states. And this was monetized, bro, on their... Ooh, that's not... That... Why? Okay, wait. This doesn't make sense. Why? But guys, apparently they've replied and said, thanks for reaching out. We reviewed the content and didn't find a violation of our policies, so no action will be taken at this time. The response reads, according to the lawsuit, which doesn't make sense. I'm pretty 1,000% sure that Twitter has like a zero policy for these kind of things. If you believe there's a potential copyright infringement, please start a new report. Copyright infringement, bro? What? If the content is hosted on a third-party website, you'll need to contact that website support team to report it. Okay, so maybe this is a bot or something. Maybe they think this is a DMCA for like a music or a video or something. Your safety is the most important thing. No. Okay, no. It's an actual person. It's okay. And if you believe you are in danger, we encourage you to contact your local authorities. Jesus Christ, bro. If that was the actual response from Twitter and it was an actual human being responding to all of this nonsense, and this is what they said, this doesn't make any sense. This doesn't make any sense. Hold on, let's make it make sense. Let me keep reading. I feel like there's something that I'm missing here. In his response, published in the complaint, Doe appears shocked. They responded, what do you mean you don't see a problem? We both are minors right now, and we were minors at the time the videos were taken. We both were 13 years of age. We were baited, harassed, and threatened to take these videos that are now being posted without our permission. We did not authorize these videos at all, and they need to be taken down, the team wrote back to Twitter. Like... This statement did not need to be said. Like, it's very clear. I'm trying to understand what is taking Twitter so long to just take down the videos. It's easy. Twitter can just easily look like a good guy and be like, oh, shoot, I can't believe that's up there. We're going to take it down and we'll research more into how it happened in the first place. Thanks for reporting. And, you know, but instead they're just like, it's like the other guys hacked into Twitter and are basically, you know, putting them at gunpoint. Like, don't you dare take this image down. Like, what is going on, bro? He even included his case number from a local law enforcement agency, but still the tech giant allegedly ignored him and refused to do anything about the illegal CP material as it continued to rack up more and more views. 2 days later, Doe's mom was connected with an agent from the Department of Homeland Security through a mutual contact who successfully had the videos removed on January 30. The suit states, quote, only after this takedown demand from the federal giant agent did Twitter suspend the user accounts that were distributing the CSAM and report the CSAM to the National Center on Missing and Exploited Children, states the suit filed by National Center on Sexual Exploitations and two law firms. So it took the government stepping in to manually remove this from Twitter for them to actually take any action, bro. And continues, this is directly in contrast to what their automated reply message and user agreement state they will do to protect children. The disturbing lawsuit goes on to allege Twitter knowingly hosts creeps who use the platform to exchange CP material and profits from it by including ads interspersed between tweets advertising or requesting the material. Guys, that is sick. I know that there is disgusting things on Twitter. I know there's disgusting things on TikTok. We've kind of talked about some of those things before. The map community and how these places and people are kind of protected in some kind of formal way. I know these things exist and it's disgusting, but this is just on another level. Like it seems like a 1 + 1 = 2 kind of equation. It's a simple problem with a simple solution that shouldn't, you know, require a person, a victim going through hoops in order to get this video taken down. You know what I'm saying, dog? Like, why did it reminds me of like the whole Cuties thing. Like, remember with the Cuties and Netflix, and they made that whole video and people were like I was thinking to myself, how did this get approved? How did this go through like 50 million different people and get approved? How did this graphic of little girls, you know, looking like they're posing in sexual suggestive ways, how did that get approved as the cover of this? What is going on? How are so many people basically accepting this stuff? So to me, it doesn't make sense, because if you're a Twitter giant, it's kind of like, you know, obviously you would want to avoid any kind of scandal like that. And obviously you would have a zero policy, zero tolerance. So the person who saw this should be like, oh, Jesus Christ, I can't believe this exists on our platform. Good. Thank you for letting us know. I'm sorry this happened to you. We're going to get it removed. End of story. That's what should have happened. So I'm just trying to understand, not only, you know, did they get like a no comment, you know, like Twitter wasn't just there, they got a negative response. I'm confused, and I feel like maybe we're missing some information. I'm not sure yet. Anyway, to finish the article, it says early Thursday, Twitter declined comment to the post, but later in that day, reversed course and sent a statement by email. So this is what Twitter basically said. Twitter has zero tolerance for any material that features or promotes CP exploitation. We aggressively fight online CP and have heavily invested in technology and tools to enforce our policy. A Twitter spokesperson wrote, our dedicated teams work to stay ahead of bad faith actors and to ensure we're doing everything we can to remove content, facilitate investigations, and protect minors from harm both on and offline. So Twitter is not saying anything here outside of just saying, this is our policy and this is what we do and this is what we have been doing, but they actually have not responded specifically to this specific lawsuit. So anyway, yeah, I started looking at the replies on Twitter in terms of this post, and it's not even worth going into. You know, people turn this into political agendas, being like, oh, Trump and blah, 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 just, you know, garbage human being stuff. But to me, something about this does not add up, because it doesn't add up. Okay, if you guys don't know, there's this community too on Twitter as well. I think it's called MAPS. MAPS stands for like minor attracted persons, people who are attracted to minors or something like that. And it's in a community where there are minors and people who are attracted to minors, and they say that it gets a sickness, and they're like a protected community on Twitter. I'm not even going to go into that, but that's a huge ordeal that's been happening on Twitter. So with this kind of falls in line with, you know, being involved with minors as well. And if there's a zero tolerance policy, I don't understand what's going on. It doesn't seem like Twitter didn't respond directly to this, but they are definitely 100% under fire for this entire investigation. None of this makes sense, but essentially the act of this lawsuit is officially allowing Twitter to get, you know, Twitter canceled. And when I say Twitter canceled, obviously that means you're getting canceled, but not really canceled because it's on Twitter. But yeah, that's basically what happened. It completely sucks that all of this did occur. If it did occur, again, the word alleged is being using a lot, just because, you know, I guess there's one side of the story and I guess there's Twitter's side of the story as well. So the lawsuit is saying that, hey, all of these things took place. We don't know what Twitter is going to say. My guess is that this will be settled out of court. My guess is they're probably going to win this lawsuit. If the claim that they're making in here is true, they're probably going to win whatever this lawsuit is. I don't know how much they are suing Twitter for, but I imagine it's probably a lot. And I mean, I'm sure Twitter can afford it, but I don't know. We'll see. If Twitter, you know, fights against it, then we'll probably have more information in the future. But yeah, that's some disgusting stuff. It sucks, because I honestly thought it would just be like bots and, you know, humans kind of like not picking up on it until the last minute. And sometimes that happens on Twitter, you know what I'm saying? You can upload like 15 seconds of like, I don't know, Adam Levine, and, you know, you upload that boink, and then as soon as you upload it, boom, you get banned on Twitter immediately, suspended, DMCA. Like, that's how fast they are when it comes to some of the most petty stuff you'll see on the internet. I remember one of my black friends, he said the N-word on Twitter, and then he got suspended immediately. Like, so like for them to respond this, not even just slow or no response, a negative response, it doesn't add up. But yeah, that's the story in a nutshell, guys. And that's the situation of how Twitter is officially getting canceled. So let me know what you guys think about in the comments section below. I'm going to keep following this because, I mean, obviously it's good to spread awareness. You guys need to know that Twitter does have this kind of stuff, and it's good to speak out about it so that we can kind of make things happen here on this platform. I think more awareness that this problem exists will, you know, increase the policies that Twitter already has in place. And hopefully it will make it so that if cases like this do happen in the future, that it'll happen faster, you know, that it'll happen quicker, and there won't be any negative response that says, hey, actually, we're just going to keep monetizing your video. You need to provide more proof or something like that. Like, bitch, what? I mean, anyway. All right, I'm out. Thanks for watching the video. I'll see you guys later. That's all I have for today. I wanted to come in person to talk about this just because it was just such a sensitive subject. I didn't want to make it like a whole lay it on me. I just wanted to kind of just read the article with you guys. So that's all it was today. So yeah. All right, I'm out. You guys stay hydrated, stay safe, and have a good one.